Hi friends, in this video I'm gonna review Samsung TUE60F model. It is one of the latest models released by Samsung in 2020.
Samsung claims that this is TU8 series. I bought this 138 cm, that is 55 inches model. You can see model over here. And it is manufactured in April 2020.
This TV comes with Crystal Ultra HD display. Obviously, Samsung has Tizen operating systems. This plays 4K videos. Then it also supports Apple AirPlay. It has 3 HDMI ports. So all these ports I will show you in detail. I bought this TV just 5 days back from Flipkart. So I got it delivered within 2 days, and within next day I got the installation done by Samsung guy, and I got it for 48,500 rupees. Let's have a look at ports provided with this TV. This is the power cable. It has two USB ports, out of which one is dedicated for dongle or data card. It is one of the way for internet connectivity. Second USB port. Here you can connect your pen drive or hard disk. There are total 3 HDMI ports. Out of them, one is ER port, which is dedicated for sound. There is one antenna input port. It also has this optical digital audio output port. It has then audio video input ports. It also has RJ45 port for LAN connectivity. And one good thing with this TV is it has some grooves where you can fit in your wires. You can see. This smart remote comes with this TV. It has Bluetooth connectivity. When you are connecting this remote for the first time with TV, you have to hold these two buttons simultaneously for around 3 seconds and it will get connected. As you can see, there is a power button, there is a microphone. This button is for voice control. This is to display number pad on the TV. This is for the ambience mode. This is for navigation purposes. You can go left, right, up and down. This is to select any program. This is to go back. This is to go home. This is to play and pause video. This is to increase or decrease volume. This is for channel. And there are these three extra keys to go to these applications directly.
Let's have a look at TV. So this is the model I got. The design and quality looks really premium. The bases are really thin. There is a one power switch over here with which you can turn on and off the TV. So currently I'm using this normal stand. Along with this normal stand, I also bought this one more stand, but I'm not using it right now because it makes it really difficult to use ports at a time. So let me quickly turn on the TV and show you the video quality and features of it. So the TV is on. This is home screen of Tizen operating system. On home screen you can see, you can set up your own account. And there will be few pre-installed apps. Also I have downloaded few and put it over here. So you can download the applications available over here and put it here. Put it on the home screen. Also, if you go down, you can see some of the recommended videos, movies. Let's go to the setting and see what we can do. So there's the e-manual. You will get entire content regarding this TV in the e-manual. There is a picture mode, you can select dynamic, standard, natural and movie mode. The sound output options, you have HDMI, then optical, then TV speaker. If you select TV speaker, you have option to set this the sound mode. It can be standard, adaptive or sound. Currently I am using this HDMI. I have connected my JBL bar with HDMI to ER port. Also you will have this Bluetooth speaker options. So I have already paired few devices. You can connect it anytime. this is timer, you can set it for to turn off TV after some time. Then regarding internet connectivity, you will have three options. There is currently I have connected with the Wi-Fi. Then you can connect the TV with RJ45 Ethernet port. It's at the back. And also you can connect it via dongle or data card. So there is one USB port for that, dedicated for that. Yeah, so regarding device care, if you wanna check, means it's kind of self-diagnosis. So you can go, I can quickly show you how we can do the video test over here. So if you go to self-diagnosis, you can go to video test. And we can see 4K video is playing. So the picture quality looks really nice, and Samsung claims that it's PQI, that is picture quality index of this particular model is 2100. So thus the video looks normal. It's normal. So likewise you can do other test, so that's fine. Then let's come to the sources. Here you can see there is a normal TV connectivity. Then I have connected this JBL soundbar by HDMI, that's why it's showing like that. Then also I have connected one pin drive at the back. And there are a few other options. Also you can go to search. This is the overall search. Here you can search via voice control also. There's a Bixby voice control system over here. Then there are certain apps. You can go to App Store. There will be a bunch of apps available with this Tizen OS also, but compared to Android, it will be very less. So Android has a lot and lot of apps. So I have downloaded few apps. I can show you those, that list. So it's like Aerosmith, Facebook Watch, Aztec, Bloomberg, India TV. Then there is Jio Cinema, Sony Live, Hotstar, and few more. So, let me show you one 4K video on YouTube. Let's go to the search. Let's use the Bixby now. So you can hold, you can press this button and hold. 4K video. Yeah, so it is giving us some results. Let's play this video. This recording, I'm not sure how much you will be able to judge the video quality, but in my opinion, this 4K video on this screen is looking amazing. So let's try to play a video of 1080 and let's see how does it look like. So this is a 1080 quality. Change back to 4K.
So that's pretty much about this TV. I can say this has very nice picture quality. The connectivity options, the ports available, and the features are more than good enough. So overall, it's very nice and good to go model. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.